Ukraine introduces scheduled blackouts nationwide following days of Russian missile attacks. The blackouts began Thursday, with the Ukrainian president's office saying minimizing the use of electricity was necessary as the enemy again destroyed generating facilities. Russian missiles hit power and water facilities across Ukraine Tuesday. The attacks disrupted water and power supply to several regions, including the capital, Kyiv. A third of the country's power stations have been destroyed by Russia. Russian President Vladimir Putin declares martial law in four Ukrainian regions that were earlier annexed by the Kremlin in allegedly rigged referendums. The move gives sweeping powers to the Russian-installed heads of Kherson, Zaporizhia, Donetsk, and Luhansk. It also allows for the strengthening of the military and the imposition of mobility restrictions, among others. But for U.S. President Joe Biden, Putin has found himself in a difficult position that he's resorting to brutalizing Ukrainian citizens.
I think that Vladimir Putin finds himself in an incredibly difficult position. And what it reflects to me is, it seems his only tool available to him is to brutalize individual citizens in Ukraine, Ukrainian citizens, to try to intimidate them into capitulating. They're not going to do that.
Despite Putin's move, the four supposedly annexed regions are not under full Russian control. Despite global uncertainties, top business leaders in the Philippines are optimistic about the local economy, but they urge government to help small businesses. Jackie Pascual reports.
Hundreds of entrepreneurs gathered at the Philippine Business Conference and Expo organized by the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Aside from small and medium-scale enterprises, officials of top conglomerates also joined the forum, where they express optimism for growth amid global uncertainties. They are hopeful their businesses will continue to grow under the Marcos administration.
I think at this time, we just have to continue on what we're doing. And just like in any business, it will take time sometimes to bear fruits. We're very positive. And we're still going on in spite of the inflation, in spite of the dollar exchange. We're still okay.
We are building more roads. We're continuing with our connectivity from everything. Also, on the food sector, we are grateful and we are appreciative of the efforts of the government to look at food security.
Our population is growing. We have a demand, consumer base, that would be a great potential for any business. But at the same time, we have a talent base. So we want to bring in the knowledge here, the BPOs, the data centers, other parts of it. And investments are coming in.
Business leaders also urge government to streamline processes to help companies and small businesses recover. PCCI says micro, small, and medium-scale enterprises, which comprise the majority of businesses in the country, badly need government assistance.
We would appreciate if the present administrations will listen to the private sector. You can see that all of us are gung-ho in expanding in the growth. We do have our problems with the government, and if they can listen and also simplify a lot of the processes for us, then I think we would grow even more and be happier.
Be more innovative, but I think they need to focus on what the PSAC is doing, which is talking to the businesses, listening to them, and hopefully working together to make that move faster.
Assist the government in streamlining our processes, improving our processes, making sure that we encourage the government to have a more inclusive type and consistent policies and rules.
These top executives say they expect economic challenges to continue in the coming months due to external factors, but they're telling Filipinos to be patient as they will continue to invest and expand their businesses domestically. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Some good news for those planning to take trips next month. Airfares are set to go down in November after the Civil Aeronautics Board ordered airlines to cut fuel surcharges. CAB said the fuel surcharge should go down to level 8 from level 9 as jet fuel prices average at over 42 pesos per liter. This means the fuel surcharge for domestic flights will range from 253 to 787 pesos and between 835 pesos and 6,208 pesos for international travel. Flag carrier Philippine Airlines says the new surcharges will apply to tickets that will be purchased as soon as next month. AirAsia and Cebu Pacific, meanwhile, expect higher flight demand following the adjusted fees.